all these are related. Short run costs. In short run, we will come across fixed costs, variable costs, and semi-variable costs are the costs. Those are in between. Those costs which are not going to be included in fixed or variable costs, such costs will be treated as semi-variable costs. And by using this fixed cost and variable costs, in short run, we are going to come across the total costs. In long run, only variable costs will be there. So up to this, we have completed in the previous class. Today, we will go for the next cost concept, that is marginal cost. So marginal cost means what? Can you tell me? Marginal cost means? Some network problem is there, I think. I have not kept a lobby, no? Why some of them are joined in lobby? Okay, so next comes this marginal cost. This will be helping you to know how this how a production, additional production is going to be added to the cost. You are going to produce additional product. Additional means, suppose if you have produced 100 units now, but if you want to go for the 101 product, what is that one product is going to increase your cost? Is nothing but the marginal cost. So this can be identified to know that how much we need to incur more for adding more output. So for that, marginal cost will help you. And this marginal cost will be included in cost itself. And when you bring change in the level of production, this marginal cost will exist. Examples you can take for marginal cost, as I said, when you are going to produce some quantity of output, and they want to know what is the additional cost. For example, if we are going for a new factory, what is the additional cost you need to incur on that particular new building? Is nothing but called as marginal cost. So adding something, some more cost to the existing one is nothing but the marginal cost. So this can bring you in increasing in your production, in making the decision of related with whether to increase your quantity of output or not. For that sake, this marginal cost will help you. And these are not related with the fixed cost. So whatever may be the fixed cost, that is not going to be related with the marginal cost. So marginal costs are always related with the total cost. So how much you have spent for additional output, that is known as what? Marginal cost. So this can be calculated by using the formula that two different levels of output will be having two different total costs, no? For example, here I gave you one pair of shoes. So this one pair is costing 330 rupees, means if you go for the next pair of production, so there if you have spent 340 rupees, what is this total cost of a first pair and this second pair? Is difference is nothing but called as marginal cost. That means this indicates the 10 rupees which you are going to incur here. 340 minus 330, 10 rupees you are going to incur if you are going to produce the second pair. So that will be clear how much a total cost will be increased if you go for the increase in the production. So this can be calculated by using this formula, MC is equal to triangle TC. Triangle TC indicates, triangle always indicates a change. Change in the TC will give you the marginal cost. This is most important in any production decision making. So this can be shown in a graph. So along with the production, marginal cost will be decreasing at the beginning stage, and it will reach us to a minimum level, and then it starts increasing. So by that we can see here in the graph, it will be marginal cost curve will be always in U shape. So at the beginning of production level, from zero, if it is going to increase up to this point where I am pointing out the cursor, marginal costs are decreasing. And if you go on increasing your production than this point that is minimum point, so if you still increase your production, that will increase your marginal costs. So additionally, you will be spending more than what it is required. So due to some any reason like wastages or whatever it may happen, due to that, the cost may be, total cost may be increasing more. So always marginal cost curve will be in a U-shaped manner. This is how we can show the marginal cost curve. And how these are related with that, we will see in this relationship between the average cost and the marginal cost. There we will go in detail, but for cost concepts up to here it is enough. And along with the marginal cost, we need to study about the average cost. Why these average costs are required? Average means per each unit how much you are spending, that is identified by this average cost. So this will help you in fixing the price of the product. So this can be calculated by using one formula, that is if you take the average of variable cost and average of fixed cost and you sum up both those, you will get average cost. Or otherwise you can take the total cost and divide it with the quantity that you have produced. That also gives you average cost. You can use any of the two formulas to identify what is the average cost. So this average cost will be influenced in short run more. So this even average cost will be reducing when production is started from zero. And after reaching a point, it starts increasing, like same like marginal cost. So there it will be more expensive. Once the total cost has increased, automatically both the average cost and the marginal cost will be increasing. So this can be analyzed in short run as well as in long run. So in short run, you can say that the average costs are related with the output, whereas in case of long run, if you are going to compare in how long run average costs are, means they are going to be varying with the usage of inputs, not with the output. So this small difference is there, which was identified the economists. How the average cost will be in case of short run as well as in long run. So this can, you can use this simple formula that average cost is equal to total cost divided by number of units produced, TC by Q. Of course, you can also use this formula which I have shown here in the second point. You can find out the average variable cost and average fixed cost, and you can sum up. But in most of the cases, wherever you see this formula, AC is equal to TC by Q is going to be used. It will be very simple, no? Making two times average and adding. That will be somewhat complicated, so they will use this formula, simple formula TC by Q for finding out this average cost. So you need to show this average cost curve also. In this average cost curve also, same like a marginal cost curve, this average cost curve also flows in a U-shaped manner. So on x-axis always you have to show the output and the cost on the y-axis. And you draw the average cost curve. If you are going to plot out exactly the values, you will get the shape of average cost curve in U-shaped. So how it is that we will go in detail along with the values in the coming topic, cost output relationship. There we will discuss in detail. And the next concept that you need to identify is outlay cost and the opportunity cost. What is opportunity cost and what is outlay cost? Can anyone say? Do you have any idea? Outlay cost means these are the actually how much you have spent on your factors of production. Factors of production means nothing but the input. Like material, rent, wages, etc. Actually, how much you have spent. That is nothing but the outlay cost. This you can say that these are going to be shown in the accounts books. So exactly you know, and you are going to show them in the accounts. Whereas opportunity cost, these are not going to be shown in the account books, but they are going to be incurred. When they are going to be incurred means here opportunity name itself is giving you. If you are going to have two opportunities with you, so anyhow you need to select only one opportunity. You cannot go for both the opportunities. So in such a cases you will be leaving one and you are going to accept one. If you are having two projects with you, so one project you are going to accept. In such case the other earn on that particular project, you are going to lose, right? So that foregone amount is called as what here, opportunity cost. So anyhow, anyone will be selecting the best alternative to gain more. So, but they will not think that they are losing whatever you are leaving aside. You can also take, if you are having two job opportunities, one it is giving you 1 lakh per month and the other one it is giving you only 90,000 per month. What you are going to do? You are going to select the best one, 1 lakh per month. No? So that means 90,000 job you are leaving. So which is called as that 90,000 is called as what? Opportunity cost. So like that in manufacturing also, you are going to select the best ones. Instead of the other opportunities, even though that is going to earn to you, but you are going to select the best one, which will be which you need to leave that which is not the best one. So which we can say that in economics, opportunity cost. The same examples I gave here, and no need to give these many of examples. So these may be asked in your short answer questions somehow, all which I am going to discuss now. And the direct costs, which are also called as traceable costs. Traceable means which you can identify. And indirect costs are nothing but which you cannot identify. And unknowingly or unidentified costs will be there, which you need to incur anyhow. So this you can say Identifiable means like in manufacturing, if you are going to use raw material, etc., etc., all the inputs on which you are going to spend that, spend the amount, all those comes under the direct costs, which you can identify that for this operation, this much of material I have used, and for this operation, this much of, for example, if you take our college, for your department, separate faculty is there, no? For each faculty, the total amount that it is going to be spent on all the departmental faculty, you can identify that this much of amount is incurred to this mechanical department. Like that, you can identify, which is directly linked up with this department. But when you go for the administrative employees, so there you cannot identify them how much administrative staff is going to be used for department, mechanical department, which we can say that they are the indirect costs. You are incurring, of course, that is going to be distributed, cannot be distributed among the departments separately. Commonly, that was incurred. So which you can say that indirect costs. So like that in any manufacturing unit also, like that some common costs will be there. So which you cannot split them and allot that amount to that particular department or to that particular process, which we can call them, call it as indirect costs. Like electricity, separately in electricity, for manufacturing, if you are going to use and if you are having a separate meter for that machinery, you can easily identify that this much of power was used by this particular machinery. But if commonly you have a meter, you cannot identify how much each machine is using, how much power it is consuming. So in such case, common meter indicates that it is indirect cost. If a separate meter is there, that we can say that it is direct cost related with that particular machinery. So like that, you can take so many examples. And implicit cost, explicit cost, we can have this implicit cost means which are called also called as imputed, implied, which are included. But these are not going to be separately identified. You can also say this opportunity cost as the implicit cost. So using your internal resources towards a project without spending more, so that it comes under the implicit cost. If you are going to adjust your own inside whatever it is there, you have already bought it by purchasing, no? So, but that you are not going to easily identify how much you have spent on that particular material because it is existing in the company itself that you are utilizing for some other thing. So, but you are incurring, but you are not able to identify how much you have spent for the new thing, new product, you can say. So which are called as what? Implicit costs. So another example also given here, if you are having own building, you are not going to directly pay the rent, but if you are going to hire in another building, if you are going to take on rent, you need to compulsory incur rent, right? So that own building, you are not exactly paying, but it is incurred, which you cannot identify, which is implied. So which is called as implicit cost. Of course, if it is for domestic purpose, all these things cannot be, we are not going to concentrate on this, on all these implicit costs. But when you come to the manufacturing unit or any production unit or a company. So all these matters, how much you are incurring by using cash, without cash, how much you are utilizing, because all these things should be included in the cost of production. Then only these unknown costs are also going to be included or recovered from the by fixing the price of the product. So for that purpose, identifying how much implicit costs are there and how much explicit costs, anyhow, we are going to identify, because they are seen. You are going to see that how much you are spending, because you are spending some amount from your pocket. Without paying from your pocket, you are incurring, means that cannot be identified. So all these explicit costs can be shown in the accounts. Because you are showing in the accounts, you can easily identify that this much of amount is going to be spent. So even implicit costs should be included in your cost of production. I think it is clear for you. Implicit difference between implicit and explicit. You can give any examples, any number of examples. So even your mother giving you service, that is not going to be identified how much service she is going to give you. Free of cost, you feel that. But when it comes to a servant that who is going to work in your house, so you are going to pay them. So that amount is called as explicit cost, because you are spending, it is identified. But mother giving a service, so without charging anything, that service is also having certain value, which we can say that it is an implicit cost. So like that, so many works will be there which you cannot see that this much of amount was needed to be spent, but you will be spending actually. So which comes under the implicit and explicit costs. In the same manner, accounting and economic costs. Explicit, already I have explained, which you are going to show in the accounts. These explicit costs are also called as what? Accounting costs. So these will be used in your preparation of accounts. You are going to show it in the profit and loss account, and you are going to identify what is the net profit or gross profit that the company has earned, and due to which you can easily identify whether the company is earning profits or losses, and how much you are spending for the total amount that you are going to spending for all the expenses, you can identify. And these explicit costs will be shown in the even ledgers. You are going to prepare ledgers also. Ledgers means what, all those things we will discuss while discussing about the accounting. And one more last, I am going to end up here. Incremental costs and the sunk costs. What are the incremental costs and what are the sunk costs? Sunk cost means, so once you have incurred, that you cannot get back. Once you have spent means spent, that's all. You cannot get back if you feel that it is unnecessarily spent for this, means you cannot get back. For example, advertising you have done. You have advertised already. But the company, can you get back that advertisement cost? What you have spent? You cannot claim that back. Which we can say that they are the sunk costs. Once incurred means incurred, that's all. Godaksunnam is that antar kada. So like that. Once you have spent on your washing, making your walls whitewashed, ఇట్ వోంట్ కన్ బ్యాక్ నో. అరే ఈ కలర్ బాగాలేదు ఇంకో కలర్ వేస్తామంటే ఆల్రెడీ వాట్ యూ హ్యావ్ స్పెంట్ ఈస్ స్పెంట్, దట్స్ ఆల్ లాస్ట్. ఇంక్రిమెంటల్ కాస్ట్ మీన్స్ దీస్ మే బి ఆస్క్డ్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ది ఇంక్రిమెంటల్ అండ్ సమ్ కాస్ట్. వై ఐ ఆమ్ గివింగ్ యూ కంబైన్లీ మీన్స్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ దే మే బి ఆస్కింగ్ యూ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ దీస్. సో ఇంక్రిమెంటల్ కాస్ట్ వీ కెన్ సే దాట్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద మార్జినల్ కాస్ట్ ఆల్సో. అడిషనల్లీ హౌ మచ్ యూ హ్యావ్ స్పెంట్ ద, బట్ దేర్ ఈస్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ద మార్జినల్ కాస్ట్ అండ్ ద ఇంక్రిమెంటల్ కాస్ట్. So there we are in marginal costs, we are going to identify for each additional product how much you are spending additional cost. But here coming to this incremental cost, the total cost will be if you are producing 1000 units, how much you have spent for 1000 units, that you are going to take into consideration in this incremental cost. So that is the only difference between the incremental cost and the marginal cost. But both are related with identifying additional costs. For example, like I gave here, if the company is going to change any decision and they want to change the product, product line is changed, or sometimes level of product is changing. So in all these examples you can take. So suddenly if you are going to leave this product and if you go for additional product, or if you want to add one more product to your company by using the same machinery and all, so whatever that additionally you are going to incur, which is called as what, incremental. In case of expansion of your business, or if you want any new material that should be added to the existing one. Anyhow, if you want to bring any new thing, new modification in your product, additionally how much you are incurring, that is going to be called as what, incremental cost. Even if you are going to replace the new machinery, already old machine is there, which you want to replace it with a new machine, that also comes under the incremental cost. All these are the examples you can take. If you are going to switch the distribution channels means in case of selling your product to the sending it into the market, instead of wholesalers, if you want to have an outlet there, so to have your own outlet, it will be costing something, no? So which you can call it as incremental cost. You spend it to the wholesalers or retailers directly, you need not have any hiring any room for selling the product, right? So if you have separate outlet, then you are going to spend for hiring a building like that, no? So all those amounts comes under the incremental cost. So with that we will come to an end of this cost concepts. Any doubts in understanding these cost concepts?